Hey Dragonhearts, this is my mom, and we're gonna play 10 questions. So what that means is, I'm gonna take 5 questions, I'm gonna ask her, and she's gonna ask me 5 questions. And we're basically gonna alternate. She doesn't know what I'm gonna ask her, and I have no idea what she's gonna ask me. So it should be fun. So, do you want to go first, or want me to go first?
This almost sounds
like truth or dare, now that I think about
it.
Minus the dare portion. So, think of it as like truth. 10 truths. Okay.
Oh, I can be honest?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, you have to be honest.
That part. Okay, now let's go. Okay. I'll go first.
Okay.
Why did you decide to become an accountant on finances?
Actually, it's kind of funny. I fell into being an accountant. But when I actually was, I don't know if you remember Papa Bear, my grandfather, your dad.
Yeah, I remember my dad.
So, I used to be in his room all the time, like him and grandma's room, I would count money. And I, for some odd reason, I would count money all the time. So I would take his bank, because he has like a little money bank that he put coins in. I would take them out, and I would count them. And then I would put them back. And then the next night, I would count them again. And I would keep doing that, like night after night, for like the longest time. So that's probably why I became an accountant, eventually.
Your turn?
Okay, so my name's Marquise. Well, actually, it was Marcus, or whatever.
It's Marcus. Marcus Antoine Green, but go ahead.
But what was your second choice for my name?
My first choice for your name, because your name came from your father, was Maurice Jr.
Okay.
I want you to be a junior.
Okay.
But Maurice did not want you. Your dad did not want a junior.
No junior. Okay, wait. Wasn't dad a junior?
No third. He wasn't credited with the name Maurice. He didn't want Maurice.
Come like, wait a second. Granddad's name was Maurice.
Maurice. What was Herbert?
Yeah. Like, they weren't exactly juniors, but they're pretty close to it.
Okay.
Your turn.
Oh, okay. Put it to the age I could get from you. Okay, next question. Okay, now that you finished school on your own and doing accounting, would it be anything you've done different now? Hindsight is 2020. Mm-hmm. Would it be anything you've done differently?
Done differently, like in career-wise?
Career-wise.
Okay.
Career, school.
Definitely. We're done school totally different. I would not have gone to college right away. Because I really didn't know what I was going to be doing. So the first year, granted I got honors, which is really weird. But the first year I didn't know what I was doing. And I had no idea when I went to college what to do. I just had a major and that was it. So if I had to do it again, I probably would have taken some time out. Maybe a year, and done either a travel thing, or just kind of find more of who I was at the time. For you, was nursing your first pick, or was just somebody to pick that happened?
Nursing was not my pick at all. It wasn't even in the lineup of what I wanted to do growing up.
Okay.
My first pick was to be a nun.
All right.
Couldn't do that because I wanted to get married and have kids.
My second pick
was a teacher.
Okay.
A couple things changed that. Working in a couple of offices with adults as a teenager. Adults, I'm mean sometimes. So that ended a teacher. And then I wanted to get married to your father. And I thought they came to school one day when I was graduating in 11th grade. They came in and said, hey, you can become a nurse in 12 months and make X amount of dollars. I thought, oh, fantastic. I'm go to high, in my 12th grade, be in high school for 12th grade, go to nursing school, graduate, and get married. It was until December of that year that they told us, oh, by the way, you got an extra year to go to school. Yeah. So that's why I became a nurse. because I wanted to get married.
Okay.
And my grandmother, the great mother, grandmother on daddy's side, was shocked. She, like she said, how are you going to be a nurse when you can't stand blood?
That might be an issue. I can see that as an issue.
Yeah, because it was an issue when I first started.
So is that still an issue? Not one of my questions, but is that still
an issue?
Oh,
wait, that's not fair. That is not an issue. No, this is not my blood. I don't care. I can give needles. I don't like needles. I can draw blood. I don't like my blood being drawn.
Okay, so long as it's not you.
Long as it's not me, I can do anything I need.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Was that my question to you?
All right. Okay, you mentioned travel. Where do that's the place you already been?
Mm-hmm.
Where in the world, if it was unlimited funds or was a free travel, where would you go and why? One question.
Okay, we'll take that as one question.
Okay.
All right. So, I don't know, honestly, because I thought about it before. Like, okay, if I had all the money and I didn't have to worry about finances and I had the time, what do I really want to go do? And you know, when I was a kid, I really wanted to go to Japan.
Yeah.
But the Japan I wanted to go to doesn't really exist because that's more like ancient Japan. So, okay. I can't say, well, because the way it worked was, like, when I was a kid, I had all these video games of ancient society. Like ancient Rome, all that. Well, you can't actually go visit that. So, what you can do is, and museums aren't the same, but what I really would like to do is kind of go to see a monastery, spend a year there, just being there with them and learning. I think that would be a lot of fun. Well, that would be fun for me, but it'll also be a lot of studying and learning that I would be doing.
Well, that's fun for you.
That is fun for me. Maybe not for other people. Okay. What was your favorite childhood tradition in family?
In our family, or family as my mom and dad?
Family with mom and dad. With your mom and dad.
Favorite childhood tradition?
The
holidays, Christmas. One of the things we had Christmas is no one could go to get to Christmas room until everybody got up.
Okay.
And wait for Santa. My daddy was big on Christmas.
Uh-huh.
I mean, he had the Santa Claus, the reindeers, the lights. It was just a whole festival season.
Okay.
And that was one of my favorite traditions. Dinner consists of turkey, ham, you know, the whole, and it's the same dinner every year, but it's still something you look forward to because it's what you did.
Okay.
Yeah, it's my favorite.
All right,
now back at you then. Okay, of all the trips you've been on as a child,
mm-hmm.
to visit several places all across the United States, what was your favorite and why? I love the why.
Right? You can ask a question and add a why to it. It's like two questions.
Yeah, that's all one. And why, that's all one.
That's actually pretty good. We've been to a lot of different places. One of the ones that stands out a lot is actually King's Dominion. And I don't know why that one stands out in my mind.
Okay. King's Dominion is right in his backyard. Go ahead.
I think one of the reasons is all the immediate family were there. When we do have a lot of pictures and things that we did during that time period. Because the camping, we went camping a lot. But because it's camping, all the scenery is like a lot of trees. So it's not like I go, well, we went here at camping, and then
Pocahontas,
then Bear Creek, then Georgia,
all the same.
So to me, all of them are like one big trip. So I can't be like, well, here, because one, I didn't even know their names. We're just camping. Only difference is like we're at a different mountain, and I did enjoy doing that a lot, hiking up the different mountains and looking out. Because you can see so far when you're actually up at a peak, or on a plateau and at the edge. Granted, I'm still scared of heights, but being able to do that is a lot of fun. And you really do get to see a lot of different things. Sunsets on the mountain is really beautiful. So, can't name the places. Maybe when I'm older, I can go back and be like, this is this place. But doing stuff like that was a lot of fun.
That's impressive.
where would you like to go? Like, now that you're older and you're going to be retiring at some point, where do you want to travel to?
That whole world. I would really if I could take the time and the money to do a world tour, you know, get on one of those and they have the flights. I've lived into one where you start at one city and you circle the whole globe going the same direction, stopping anywhere from 5 to 20 times depending on what you want.
Okay.
At each city, continent, till you come back to where you started from. Oh, that would be my ultimate trip.
Okay.
Yeah, that would be my ultimate trip. If I had to pick one place, probably Paris.
Paris? Okay. Will you learn French again? Or we just go with, you know, try to learn while you're there?
Immersion would be fun.
Immersion?
Immersion.
Okay.
I was still doing it. Came to class in immersion.
Okay.
But, yeah. My turn?
Yes, your turn.
Okay. All the people in your family, remember your mother's sitting right in front of you. Who do you think you're most like? Your mother's sitting right here. And
my mom, of course. Because she's sitting right here.
Now.
All my best qualities come right from her. Yes.
That's true. And I think it works from your father. No. Great father. No, seriously. Okay.
I don't know. Because I really take after a lot of different people. And it has to do with the way in which I grew up. I mean, I grew up in grandma's house. So I have all my older aunts and uncles that grew up with me. Then, of course, I grew up also with my other grandmother, with her, and my eldest aunts and uncles. Seeing them all the time, growing up in the church, more than one different church. Then, of course, you and dad, that was a big thing. So I picked up a lot of different little quirks from different people. So I don't know if there's like any one particular person I act like. I think it's just a pretty good melding of like everybody.
That's a good answer. I agree that when I look at you and see you, I see, depends on what you're doing and where and what's going on, I see a little bit of everybody. Mm-hmm. Which is a good thing.
I think so.
You got the best of everybody. That's good.
Yeah. We're not go with the worst. We're just go with the best.
Oh, the best. You must say the best.
I guess that's 5 questions. Or more than 5 questions. I honestly totally forgot my doom track. But anyway, thank you for playing 10 plus questions with me.
Okay.
And that's it.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed it.
If y'all like it, hit the like button. Subscribe if you want to. Comment, ask us questions that you wanted to know, and hit us up on Facebook or Instagram. All right, see y'all.